All right, we're at the Blue Note Grill tonight, and we're going to be mixing for the Groovynators, and it's been quite a while since we've been here. And tonight could be the last night that the Groovynators will be performing. They've gone on to some different things. Okay, the lead singer of the Groovynators is Dennis Beckwith. He has his own project going on right now called Beckwith. Now it's to my understanding that the Groovynators may be bringing in some other musicians to fill in. So the Groovynators could be going on, but at this point I'm not too sure if it's going to be the same kind of format. It's been a pleasure mixing for the Groovynators for the past many, many years. And in fact, I started mixing for them and working with them prior to even doing these videos, or actually even having this channel. They're great guys to work with. They've always had good music. So this could be the last night for it. We're going to get the board set up and hopefully get all the stuff done quickly so we can help the band get the stage set up. All right, we're going to be setting up the console for the Groovynators. We need to tape the board and figure out what inputs we're going to be using. And right now there's another band on stage, and they're using a mixer up there, and it's they're sending the output over to this one channel. Okay, like last shows here in the past, we haven't been able to do a sound check just because of all the people in here. But having mixed the band before on this equipment in here, I know pretty much where to sort of start everything. So I'm going to go through and rough in a lot of the settings. Okay, we just set the high pass filter on most of the channels. All right, at this point, I think we only need one phantom power where the red light is on before the snare and hat. Okay, the 20 dB pad was turned on a couple of channels. I just turned it off. That's going to be about it. That all this is from when I've mixed them before on this console. And the other thing I got to do here is, I think what we used here before. We're just going to add a little bit of reverb for all the vocals. And I usually add some into the snare. It's not much, but if I need more during one of their slow songs or a ballad, I can just add a little bit more reverb on the channel itself. They've got high pass filtering. I think you need to bump this stuff up here. They're calling it the low cut on here. Okay, I just noticed they're not using the monitors on here, so I'm going to go ahead and set this stuff now. So, monitor one is stage right. I usually try to do about 16, and I don't know how accurate the Behringer stuff is, but that's it. It's a place to start. Once the band gets done, the band that's on stage right now, once they get done, I'm going to have to go through. I'm going to sort of flatten the stuff out. I'm going to need to take down a few frequencies that have been known to be issues within the room. Hooked up. We're trying to get stuff done maybe a little bit more quickly. Set the gain on that. No high pass. Got the master monitors turned up. We're testing the vocal mic in this moment. Yeah. We're gonna do lead singer right now. Alright, we can give him some monitors. He should be on two. Yeah. All right, we're going to have him check the sax. We've had a bad cable. Looks like a sax is set. Okay, we're gonna do the vocals on the keys. What else is on here? Okay. Let's do the keys. Thank you. gain is set. Alright, we'll do the horns now. Alright, that looks good. The horns look good. Okay, we're going to do doing the guitar. Guitar! Yeah. Trim level looks good. Right, let's try to bring up some front of house so we can not hear them.
Thank you.
So the band's taking a break. It sounds really good, and we had an issue with some feedback coming through the monitors. Now the gain settings are all pretty much the same as what we've usually used it on the board. All the EQ is pretty much the same. I've had to make a few minor adjustments. But so I'm not too sure what's going on, but I had to go through and notch out some of these higher frequencies out of all of the monitor channels. That seems to have fixed the... That seemed to fix the feedback. Thank you. Yeah, thank you. So the last few songs, we didn't have any more monitor feedback, so we're going to see how that goes into the second set. All right, we're using the mac and cheese plug-in on the console. It seems to be working pretty good. We're using the subgroups, so that means that we can leave all of the faders, all of the levels, pretty much leveled. I've got the bass turned down. The bass is the only one that's going, it's bypassing the subgroups and going directly to front of house. But we don't need to touch any of the levels here. All I had to do is just bring down the subgroup levels. All right, so they still have a channel down over here, but we did have an extra channel for this, and actually I put the overhead on it, which is part of the drums over here. So it's no big deal just to reach over here and bring up the overhead. I usually don't need to move it too much. But it is part of the drum channels over here. It's been a pleasure mixing for the Groovynators for probably the past maybe 10 or 11 years. All right, that's the end of the show. We're just going to take stuff down and zero the console out.